Day one. Fire ant nuptial flight with exotic slayer.
We found queen ants in the bin.
Mikey, come here, like right now.
There's a lot.
Oh my god.
You wouldn't believe me.
Dude.
We're catching fire ant queens.
So Look many. At that.
There are so many.
Oh my, they're on the floor.
Maybe the males aren't out yet. See, look at how many we've caught.
That is crazy.
Day three. One of the fire ant queens actually laid eggs. And here she is, in all her glory. The queen fire ant sits caring for a big pile of eggs. This queen had already broken off her wings right when we caught her, which can be a good indicator that she had already mated. But just so you guys know, there is still a chance she hadn't. Day 10. Update. Guys, I have some news to share about the queen fire ant we caught over a week ago. What I spotted in our queen's test tube left me speechless. Please subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon. Welcome to the AC family. Enjoy. I've been waiting with great anticipation to see if our precious queen fire ant we caught that laid eggs in last week's episode was showing signs of being successfully fertilized. In other words, whether or not she had mated during the nuptial flight from which we captured her, or if she was still a virgin queen ant whom we captured too early and was just destined to die. Well, I have some good news for you and some bad news that may shock you, and I'll get to what I spotted in her test tube this week. This has been an insane past 10 days, to say the least. Alright, AC family. So the two pieces of news to share with you. I'll start with the bad news first. I peeked into the box of queen fire ants that I had collected and test tubed on the night of the nuptial flight, and I was totally heartbroken to see this. Eggs totally scattered, and the queen fire ant on her back, struggling, with her legs flailing in attempts to get back up. It broke my heart to see the queen fire ant look at us as she was on her way through the death process. Sadly, our queen ant here was dying, her pile of eggs scattered about and uncared for, both telltale signs that she had failed to mate during the great fire ant nuptial flight from 10 days ago. I'm sorry, queen. You will be gone too soon. But in my heart, I knew that this was just all part of the sometimes harsh realities of ant life. You see, not all queen ants successfully mate, nor make it to founding full colonies of their own. I placed her back into the box with the rest of the queen fire ants, who also were on their way to dying, as none of them had laid eggs and were definitely not mated. Rest in peace, fire ant queens. May you all proceed now, in peace, to the divine land where all ants fly after their hour of death. And now for the good news. The queen fire ant from last week's video was not part of that death box. She's here, alive, healthy, with a much bigger egg pile. And guess what else? As I looked closer, I spotted a larva. Yay! One of the eggs had hatched. This was an amazing sign. And AC family, that's not all. After turning her test tube a little, my eyes widened as I spotted the big larvae batch. Whoa, so many larvae. All right, now although this doesn't guarantee our queen fire ant here has been fertilized, as these larvae might turn into males if she isn't. And yes, if you're new to ants, unfertilized eggs become male ants due to the weird intricacies of ant genetics. And in case you're wondering, no, she can't mate with her own sons to get fertilized. But the great news is, seeing all these larvae all organized like this makes me feel a good 85% certain that our queen fire ant is indeed mated. Any experienced ant keeper knows that a brood pile that looks like this pretty much certifies that our queen has successfully mated during her nuptial flight, and that a fire ant horde was soon on the way. So great. And I scared you for a sec there, with that first queen, didn't I? I know. I was scared at first too, thinking that was our official fire ant queen. Before remembering, I had actually separated our official queen fire ant with eggs from the batch, the day I discovered she laid eggs. But guys, speaking of which, I think it's time we officially name our fire ant queen here, with brood, shall we? In last week's video, a lot of you gave some really great name suggestions as to what we should name her. So, I've chosen my top 5 favorite names and posted them under the pinned comment of this video. Simply check the replies under the pinned comment and give a thumbs up on the name you vote for. And the name with the most number of likes by next week will be our Queen Fire Ant's official name, to be announced in next week's video. Thank you, AC Council, for your input. It's pretty amazing to see the larvae. They're quite cute, with their little hairs, known as setae. It helps the larvae adhere to each other and to surfaces in their environment, like the test tube walls. Now I can see from the yellowish color within their bodies that the larvae have already been feeding from the queen's self-made nutritious soup that the queen's body has been naturally manufacturing from muscle tissue stores in her back, which used to power her wings during nuptial flight. With no more wings now, all those valuable wing muscles can now be broken down and used for nutrition. The nutritious soup made from the queen's former wing muscles will be enough to nutritionally sustain the queen and her first generation of young to maturity. These larvae will pupate and later eclose to become the queen's first set of workers, known as nanitics. These nanitics, once they arrive, have a huge responsibility to essentially pioneer the colony at its infancy. So much rests on the success of these first larvae, who will become the ultimate determining factors towards whether or not this fire ant colony in the making succeeds to grow into a massive fire ant colony, or whether they fail, leading to this colony dying out. One of the biggest jobs the nanitics will be in charge of will be finding the colony's first real meal, because the queen's self-made nutritious soup that she's been feeding them is only just enough to raise the nanitics to maturity, and after that, will completely run out. Go larvae, grow! You are the queen's only hope now. But as for us, all we can do at this stage to help is keep this fire ant queen in peace and undisturbed as much as possible. I place the test tube into a darkened cupboard where the queen can be free from vibrations and light, both of which can stress her during this crucial founding period. But AC family, I am totally thrilled that so far everything is running smoothly, and it looks like we have a promising fire ant colony, with the nanitics officially arriving very soon. Fire ant colonies grow extremely quick, so once these nanitics arrive, and they get to eat their first meal, probably a blob of honey water, they'll consume it and feed it to the queen and growing brood, which will get the colony to truly explode exponentially. For those of you who followed the growth of my last fire ant colony, the Phoenix Empire, you know how quickly these ants can go from a cute little batch of scrawny ants to a pulsating, beastly, and stinging horde of millions. Let's enjoy that process and watch it all unfold before our very eyes, once again with this new fire ant colony. Once the nanitics do arrive, I think that will be a great time to give the colony an official name. But until then, leave any name suggestions you might have in the comments. Thank you all for watching, and please do remember to hit that like button, as it really helps a lot to let YouTube know you enjoy these ant videos and that they're worth sharing to new audiences. And hit the subscribe button to be part of this new and exciting journey as we raise this new queen fire ant and her promising brood into a powerful fire ant kingdom to take its place once again as the ultimate ant colony of the channel, just as their predecessors did in the past. It seems fire ants, though undoubtedly the most difficult ant species I've ever owned, still always seem to somehow manage to make their way into our ant-loving hearts and burn a lasting mark into our minds and souls. It's always an adventure owning these guys, and I have some epic plans ahead for them if they do make it to maturity. But until then, I'll see you all next week as we check up on the progress of our beloved fire ant colony in the making here. Thank you all for watching and supporting the ants. It's ant love forever. Hope you can subscribe to the channel as we upload every Saturday at 8 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. Please remember to like, comment, share, and subscribe if you enjoyed this video to help us keep making more. It's Ant Love, forever.